Hello and welcome to the ASCET Developer screencast. Today I will show you how to get started after installing the tool. So once you have created a new ASCET workspace, let me show you the tool concepts with an example which we ship with the product. So I choose File, New, Example, and I choose the boat computer example. Set Finish. In the Project Explorer, you can see that there are many files, and the most important file in an ASCET project is the ESDL file. Let me open the boat computer ESDL to explain the concepts. The ESDL is where ASCET stores the meaning of your model. It looks and feels like any modern programming language. As you can see here, there's a notion of packages and namespacing. You can import types which have been defined in other classes. And the class description is here. So there is a static class called as boat computer. It reads and writes from some interface. This is the outline view which shows you the content of this ESDL file. So here you can see there is a boat computer. These are the class elements. There are three methods. As a user, you have the choice to also write code for this ESDL class from graphical, to generate code for this ESDL class from graphical editors. So as you can see, there is a special annotation add generated block diagram, which means that the code for this method has been generated from a graphical block diagram editor, which is this PD file. Let me open that. And if you look at the outline view, this graphical editor generates code for this static class. Here is a palette from which you can create class elements or drop them on the canvas, connect them together. And so there is data flow and control flow describing your behavior. And you can see here in this example, there are two signals, the velocity in meters per second, the reset signal which go into this block, and they calculate the distance. You can double click and go inside. And in this class, you can also invoke code, reusable code from other classes. So in this example, we are using the code from a turn on delay class, which is written directly in the ESDL editor. And all this code is saved in the ESDL file. There is also another graphical editor like the state machine editor, so you can also write ESDL code in a graphical state machine, and this also gets saved in the ESDL file. There you go. And this ESDL class also has code which is generated by a block diagram, the display toggle.bd, and there is some code written directly in ESDL itself, like this method is sub-zero. Then there is an .app file. Let's open that. The application file is used for code generation. You have to tell ASCET what are the entry point classes for you for which you want to generate code on this side. And then on the right hand side, you can also create task containers and assign threads from your static class to the various task containers. Then select the application, run as, and then you can generate code for different use cases. So you have the main use case, which is the control unit code generation, or you want to do a PC experiment with it, or transfer it to another tool for external bypass like Integrio or an FMU build. We will do, let me see, code generation. So what ASCET does is, after successful code generation, it creates an Eclipse CDT project and dumps all the source code there, all the header files and the C files. let me close all these open editors and let me open the source code for the board computer file. So there you go. And because this is a CDET project, it's possible for you to navigate across all the source code simply by just selecting something and saying open definition, open declaration, all the features of Eclipse CDT essentially. And in this C file, you can see that ASCET has generated optimized C code. And because ASCET is designed for safety, ASCET and thread-safe access, you can see that ASCET caches all the messages to local variables, and these are used in your method. And at the end of the method, they're written back to the global communication channel. To give you a comparison, let me open the ESDL file. I'll use the Eclipse shortcut to open the resource. Ctrl-Shift-R, I open the ESDL file. Let me maximize this and take this to a new window. And there you go. So this is your 10 millisecond process ESDL code, 10 millisecond process C code, and this ESDL code was also generated from a graphical editor, so you can also open that, the BD. So, from BD to ESDL to the final C code. Okay. As a new user, we also recommend that you read our online help. So help, help contents. It's taking some time. And there you go. And there are two chapters, the ETAS ASCET user guide and the ESDL user guide. And in this chapter, there's a getting started, which also comes with a tutorial, which walks you through all the important concepts with hands-on exercises. That's all from my side for today's screencast, and thank you for watching.